Toxic chemicals have been found in all brands of toilet paper all across the globe, raising alarm concerns about the dangers that consumers are exposing their bodies to daily. Again, you've heard it before. I've tried the first cases ever tried dealing with this PFAS product up in the Ohio River Valley. Tried five of them. That's the first time that anybody even learned about it. They made two movies about it. One was called Dark Waters. The other one was called The Devil We Know. Terrible, terrible history on this chemical. Now we find it's in toilet paper.
Yeah, it's especially troubling. As you know, this thing can cause all kinds of endocrine problems, you know, problems with fetuses, every cancer imaginable, basically. Yeah. It's poison. It is pure poison that we, as humans, as other species out there as well, 98% of us already have this in our system. We're drinking it in our water. The EPA has done nothing. They're finally saying maybe we're going to come out and start regulating this. But with it being so prevalent in all the water, it gets into all of the plants, and that's, of course, where we end up with the problem that it's now in our toilet paper.
Why do you think it's such a yawn story? You know, there's stories like when we talk about climate change, it's a yawn. You know, we talk about the environment, most of the time it's a yawn. This is a yawn story. This is where people don't understand what we're talking about here. I guess maybe we just haven't broken through. But it causes cancer. It causes birth defects. It causes brain issues, neurological issues. It causes gastrointestinal issues. We tried those cases. I personally tried those cases up in the Ohio River Valley. Actually tried them in Columbus, Ohio over a period of about 2 years. This is bad stuff. But again, you know, people are going to say, I don't know what PFAS is, therefore, I'm not worried about it.
Well, and a lot of them think, oh, well, if I'm already drinking it, if it's already in my body, clearly I have no problems right now, so I'm going to be okay. Maybe it'll flush itself out. But it doesn't do that. It's bioaccumulative.
Every time you get exposed, it builds up more in your body. It's in the environment for a million years. If it's in the soil or the water, it's there a million years, and it has the capacity to cause horrendous, horrendous physical illness. But, you know, again, you'll see this will be, I don't know.
Well, and folks need to understand, too, with it being in the toilet paper, you can actually absorb it through the skin.
Yeah.
So it's not like, oh, but I'm not eating toilet paper, it's not going to get, nope, it can be absorbed through your skin, through any body opening. It's horrendous, and people, again, don't care. And maybe it's because they feel there's nothing I can do about
it. Yeah, maybe
this.
Maybe we'll keep talking about it anyway. Litigation is making its way through Congress that could give the government unprecedented power to snoop on your internet activity, all under the disguise of preventing China from spying on your internet activity. Wow. You know what? Let me jump back in time. The first time you saw this story about TikTok, you know what you said to me? You said, Pap, let me tell you where it's going. And we sat and talked about it, and we said, absolutely, this is where it's going. Tell us where we are with this internet ridiculous story.
We're actually even worse with this legislation than I would have thought.
Yeah.
Because the Restrict Act is what it's called, and there's no mention of TikTok in it, even though it's supposed to be the bill to ban TikTok and China from taking your data. And what it does is it creates this board controlled by the president of the United States, because the Democrats, I think, don't understand that Biden's not going to be president forever.
Yeah, or maybe not even the next time, probably.
Yeah,
you know?
So, you know, you're going to put a horrible person, you know, maybe there already is one in charge. But anyway, it creates this board that is going to have broad jurisdiction, no judicial oversight, to accuse any American of engaging in illegal activity online, and they immediately get that user's entire internet history, their online purchase information, everything that person has ever done online, and you can't appeal it, you can't take it to a court, you cannot challenge it. This is dictatorship.
Well, okay, there's no appellate process. There's no review at all.
Right.
The committee that makes the decision was appointed by the president that makes the decision. I don't really like this. Let's wipe it out. You have no idea even why you've become a target.
Yeah.
They don't have a duty to even tell you why you become. Mark Warner. Now, Mark Warner, Democrat from Virginia, he's the guy behind this. He's there with John Thune.
Yeah.
And they say, oh, this is brilliant. Mark Warner. Democrat from Virginia is the guy that helped draft this. He's the one pushing it. And this is like a nightmare. I hate to use 1984. Everybody, you know, every jerkwater in the world, 1984. But this really is.
It truly is. And look, you could be facing 20 years in prison if you use a VPN to access a banned website like TikTok.
Yeah.
Or up to $1 million in fines. So if you get on TikTok with a VPN, if we've banned it, you could have to pay $1 million just to be on TikTok for a few minutes. Okay, this is insane.
Here's my prediction. Biden is not going to be reelected. Okay, he's not. I don't know who it is, but he's not going to be reelected. You're going to have a Republican, maybe another Democrat. I'm not sure, but you're going to have a different person making these decisions. So if you're saying, oh, well, I'm good with Biden making these decisions, you better be able to say, oh, I'm good with Trump making these decisions or DeSantis making these decisions. I'm fine with that. You better be able to say that before you swallow this ridiculous story, right?
Absolutely. And I'll tell you how bad this legislation is. You have AOC, Tucker Carlson, Alex Jones, Josh Hawley, Jamal Bowman, conservative media outlets, Fox News, liberal media outlets, everybody is united in warning about how terrible this is. And when you've managed to unite the entire country with how bad your legislation is, that should be clue number one.
I have got to read this. Let's take a second. This is the response. This is the committee's response when ProPublica asked them, what the hell? What are you doing? Here's what they said. Well, this gives us the ability to mitigate the national security risk posed by high-risk technology business in the U.S. and would strengthen our ability to address discrete risks posed by individual transactions and systematic risks posed by certain classes of transactions involving countries of unknown concern and unknown sensitivity. What the hell? That's word salad. And so this word salad is what they're telling everybody. Basically, that means nothing to me.
Yeah,
it's as vague as the legislation itself.
To me, what that means is, listen, Americans, if anybody's going to be stealing your data, it's going to be your own government. Right. That's what that means.
Yeah, and you're going to be okay.
Yeah,
because Biden's a good guy, and he's not going to let anything bad happen. And maybe Trump won't either. Maybe DeSantis won't either. God Almighty. Farron Cousins, thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but all these segments are going to be available throughout next week, and make sure you follow us on Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you the stories every week that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers don't let them, or their political connections to the Republican Party or the Democratic Party. They don't allow for it. We'll see you next time.